Hey there, Latin 2. So, we are on chapter 31, Pseudolus, and I'm going to go over the glossary with you first. Notice that it goes to two different pages, so beware of that. And I think maybe there's some other vocab along the way further along, so be prepared for that. This might be a two-parter. So, the first word we see is kakinous, kakini, kakinous, kakini. You can tell this is a Greek word, actually, because there's a ch, and there's two n's. Interesting, in Greek, it's kachingus, because two N's next to each other makes a G sound for some reason. Or maybe it's two G's next to each other makes an N sound. I don't remember. This is clearly a Greek word because it involves joy. So this means laughter. I always think of the word cackle. The next word we see is optimus aum, adjective, very obviously. This means the best. If you think optimist, optimal, everybody thinks Optimus Prime, which is valid. The next one is lanius, lanii, lanius, lanii. This means butcher. This is one who sells meat. So not only does he cut it, but he also sells it. Lanius. I got nothing in English, but interestingly, there's another word in Latin is leno. I'll let you look that one up, and you'll see why these are actually often paired together in various plays, and they're making a pun. The next word is caro carnis. Notice that it's feminine. Caro carnis. This means meat. It's where we get carnivore. It's where we get carnal. Carnival, actually. Carnival means saying goodbye to meat, because it's vale, carne vale. So you're saying goodbye to it. It's the beginning of Lent, if I recall. Quanti. Quanti is the plural form of quantus, and this is where we get quantum, by the way, which means you're counting every little bit. A quantum leap is actually a very small leap. People don't know that anymore. So quanti means how much or how many. Perna, perni, feminine, obviously. Perna, it means ham. Really what it means is your leg. If you're talking about someone's legs in a positive way, not a clinical way, you might use perna. In Spanish, you get pierna, but I got nothing in English for you. So, the next one, pretium, pretii. This is price. It looks kind of like price, to be perfectly honest. The next one is an important one to notice. Quidem. That's different than quidam. Quidam is quidam, quidam, quodam. This is quidem. Quidem means indeed. One little letter will make all the difference. Umquam. Umquam. Now, in English, we have the word numquam, or I'm sorry, in Latin, we have the word numquam, which means never. In English, it means never. In Latin, you have the word umquam, which means ever, which you just literally took an N off the beginning of the word, and now it means ever. And in English, if you take the N off of never, you get ever. It's just kind of a funny little thing that happened linguistically across two different languages. Procox, procacis, this means insolent. It's an adjective. It's a two-termination adjective, it would appear. Procox, procox, procox. No, it's a single termination. I apologize. But this means insolent. In slang, it means pushy. I always think it kind of sounds like cocky. Don't get cocky. The next word, autem. Autem means however, it means but most of the time it actually means moreover. So you might want to write moreover next to that, okay? In this particular context, it'll mean however or but. But very often it means moreover, like and another thing, you know? Important word, especially in level 3. Multus aum. Now, we've seen multi ia. Now it's multus aum. Here's the singular. So multi ia means many. Multus aum means much. Okay. Pinguis is a. Pinguis is a. This is a two-termination adjective. And this means fat. And I always think of it, this is a pleasant kind of fat. This is what we would call plump, because we're referring usually to meat that is pleasantly fat. It's plump. So it's thick. Pinguis. I always think of penguins are plump. So turn the page and you get denarius, denarii, which means it's coin. It's later on in Throughout North Africa, you get dinar. In England, you actually, one of the ways that they mark how many dollars something is, for them it's pound, it's quid, it's bob, it's there's all kinds of words because they can't be bothered to use the decimal system. But 12 shillings is 12D because a shilling was silver and all it's all kinds of wacky. If we're together, I'll spend like half a day just on currency alone. It'll be fun. The next one is emo. Emo means on the other hand or rather, okay, contrarily. And actually, that's where I'm going to leave it because then we can start up in the next video with my second favorite animal. There's a fun little Star Wars story about that. Anyway, I'm going to hit the button.